Hey, what's going on, guys? This is the full video lesson for Candle Boxes Far Behind. Okay, so in this video lesson, we're going to go over every guitar part, and the song consists of the intro riff, the signature intro riff, which is also the same thing that's played throughout the verses. Then you have your chorus, then you have a little chorus lead, a second guitar part comes in the chorus, which we're going to go over too. Then you have your solo section, and I'm going to walk you through the whole solo very, very slowly, so we get down every subtle nuance of the solo, played exactly as he plays it. And then I'm going to do a demonstration of the solo played at half speed, and I'm going to have the tabs on the screen as I'm playing each part of the solo at half speed. And then finally we have the breakdown at the end, which comes right after the solo, and then you have the outro riff, which is just kind of part of the final chorus. So, walk through every part. I'm not sure how long this video is going to take. I expect it to be anywhere between 45 minutes and an hour. But, hang out and check it out. Alright, so this is the intro riff of the song. This intro riff is also played throughout the verses. So, once you know this, you know all the verses as well. So, this is how this goes. If you're watching this from the website, then you have the tabs on the screen. If you're watching this on YouTube, then you don't. Otherwise, just follow along if you're on YouTube. But anyway, so it starts out with a open G string, okay, and then you do a little hammer pull from the 5 to 7 on the E, on the high E, and you alternate between the G string and the E string. So, then you do an open E string, low E string, and then you do these chords, okay, so it's, so far. And then he's basically just going to a D chord here. Alright, so the tabs may look harder than it actually is, but really he's just holding an open D chord. And he's playing the D string first, the open D string, and then just walking down the notes of the D chord. Okay, so far we have, to the D, and then he does a little walk up on the A string, okay, and you can actually use your first two fingers because you're going to be catching a C add 9 chord, okay, so you're going to be going, okay, so again, it's just a chord. If you're watching this from the website, take a look at the chord diagram that's appearing on the screen. If this is YouTube, it's a C add 9 chord. And you're not putting your pinky on the low E string. It's or a high E string. It's an open high E string. Okay, C add 9 with an open high E. So walking up, okay, so the tabs always make it look more difficult when it is. So anytime there's a chord of any sort that's just being played like that, I'm just going to add the chord diagram in addition to the tabs just to clarify that it's easier than the tabs make it appear to be. So far we have, okay, see, I accidentally walked up with my second and third finger, which caused me to have difficulty grabbing that C add 9 chord. What I should have done was walked up with my first two fingers. So let me try that again. last section of the tab that you see, where he's going, that he's just kind of doing random fills throughout the verses. Okay, so the main thing that you want to catch is that he's playing on a C add 9 chord. He's playing on this chord. And you can actually kind of do anything. You can just pick whatever random notes in that chord that you want along with the music. So you know, whatever you want to do, and just kind of walking down on the A string between the using your middle finger and your first finger. So or whatever you want to do. So basically that's it. You're just playing on those chords. So the first part is the same every time. And the second part's the same every time. And then the D chord is the same every time. And then the C add 9 is mostly the same every time, but he kind of switches that part up. Okay, so you can kind of just do whatever you want. Just know that it's a C add 9 chord with the open E string, the open high E. Okay, so that pretty much covers the intro riff and all the verses. So it's pretty straightforward. He doesn't really alter very much from that. So now we're going to get into the chorus of the song. All right, so after the verse, it goes into the chorus. And the chorus is pretty simple. He uses the same exact chords that we've been doing the whole time, except now he's just not playing all those pretty extensions and all that, okay? So basically the chords are just G, E, D, C. All right, and it's mostly power chords. If you want to do an open G chord, you can, or you can just do a G power chord. All right, so it starts out. Then it goes to the E power chord. And you can either play the E power chord down here, or you can play it up here on the 7th fret of the A string. All right, I like to do both to add some dynamics. So okay, and as I said, you can do an open G chord if you want instead of doing the power chord if you also want to add some dynamics. Okay, so just G, then E. The next one is a D power chord. So the D power chord is on the 5th fret A string. And that has a little switch up of the rhythm here, so it goes. Okay, so it's hit, or it's strum, pommy pommy strum. Alright, and then it goes down to the C on the 3rd fret. Alright, and now once it gets to the C, he does a little walk down to add some tension. So basically what he's doing is he's holding the C power chord, and then he just moves his first finger down one fret. Okay, so you're keeping your other fingers in the same position, but you're just moving your first finger down one fret to add this tension sounding chord. Hear how that sounds? Just clashy, but it leads nicely into the back into the G. Okay. Okay. So music's all about tension and release. Alright, so basically, so far you have. Alright, so that's your whole chorus right there. Now there's a little lead that comes in as well. A second guitar player comes in and does a lead during the second half of the chorus. And the way this works is he's doing these octave chords. And octave chords are just simply, you're playing two of the same notes an octave apart on the D and the G string. Okay, so if I were to play an E octave chord, for example, I'm here on the 7th fret of the A string, which is my note E. Then I'm going to put my 3rd finger down on the 9th fret of the G string. Okay, so you're skipping a string, you're skipping over the D string, and you're playing two frets down, or two frets up, whatever you want to call it. And then you're muting the D string with the meat of your first finger. So the chord's gonna sound like this. Okay, and you can play these anywhere. All right, now, basically, he goes around the chord progression once in the chorus, and the second time that the chord progression goes around, he adds in this little octave riff, which goes. Just kind of going with the I'm using my ear to be my guide as to how to play the rhythm and to when to make the changes. Okay, so when you're using these octave chords, you just it's just a way to just exude more feeling into the chord progression. Okay, so you want to make sure that you keep the D string muted at all times. The D string is going to be in between your first and third finger, because if you don't want to let that D string ring, otherwise it's going to cause a clashing sound. Okay, it'll sound bad if you do that, so you want to mute it and just play the two notes. Alright, so the whole chorus goes like this. Go around twice, but you get the idea. Okay, add in those octave chords as you see fit, and you know, the chorus is just G, E, D, C. All right, so with that said, let's get on to the solo section. That's going to take a little bit of time to hack away at it. Okay, so let's walk through every part of this solo. So basically, the solo is played over the same progression as the chorus is played over, okay? It's played over G, the G power chord, the E power chord, the D power chord, and the C power chord, looped over and over. So let's play over that. So each phrase, I'm going to show you what each phrase does over each chord, okay, because that's how soloing works. You want to think in terms of chords. So every time a chord change occurs, you want to do a little phrase. All right, that's why the best solos tend to sound so good, okay, because they're thinking in terms of what the chords they're playing over. So it starts out, it's played over the G chord. Okay, so if you're watching this on YouTube, you don't have the tabs or the chord diagrams on the screen, so just do your best to follow along. If you're watching this from my website, then you do have the tabs and chord diagrams, and you know, it'll probably be easier for you to follow along. All right, so with that said, the first part is played over G chord. Okay, so it goes. Pretty simple, right? Just 12 and 14 on the G string. And then the rhythm changes to an E chord, and it does it again. And then the rhythm changes to a D chord. And then it goes. All right, so it's just the 12-14 thing, and it's ending with a 15 fret bend. 15 fret bend on the B string. All right, and then once he switches to the C chord, he does the signature pentatonic thing, which is just a 12th fret of the high E and 15th fret of the B bending. Okay, so he does that five times. Okay, so this first progression around goes. Okay, so that's one progression around. The second time around, he's going right at the G chord, he goes. Okay, so it's just going right to the bend this time. Alright, and then once it switches to the E chord, he does this nice little phrase. Okay, so that's 12-14 on the high E, and then a 15 on the B, and then. If you have trouble bending that 15th fret of the high E, you can always just slide up to the 17 instead. You can go. All right, my fingers are a little sore from playing so much, so I'm actually, sometimes I choose to do that instead of the bend. Okay, so far we have over the G and the E chord in this phrase, or in this round of chord progression. Okay, and then once he switches to the D chord in the rhythm, he goes. Alright, so he's just doing 15, 14. And these are just half bends on the 14, okay? So you're on the 14th fret, and you're just bending to the note of the 15. Okay, so make sure you only do half bends and not full. All right, so far in this phrase. All right. All right, now this is the first fast lick, the first tricky part. So the way this works is you want to make sure that you start you want to start this phrase on an upbeat, okay? So it's. Okay. You don't have to hit it. I'm just stressing the fact that it starts on an upbeat to us. Alright, so it's. And then the second half of it goes. Just want to work with the timing of the song. So let me just put my looper pedal back on here again, and let me just try this phrase over top of it, because it sounds a lot better when it's played over top of a chord progression. Okay, one more time. Okay, so that little metronome that I have in this looper helps a lot, because you hear the hit each time. It goes hit, hit, hit. Okay, hit, hit. All right, so far we have this much of the solo. Of the solo so far. So now we have over the G chord, it's just going. Alright, so basically he's just hitting the 12th fret of the G and the B string. Alright, and then the rhythm changes to the E and it does this progression. So just follow along to tabs. Again, if you're on YouTube, you don't have the tabs, but I'm trying to play it slow enough so you can still follow along with what I'm doing. So it just kind of slides down from that 12th fret. All right, so far in this section. And then, once he's at the D chord, it goes just a high bend on the 15th fret of the B string, and then it does another one of these fast licks. So it goes. So he's hitting the 16th fret on this G string, which is the same note as the 12th fret on the B string. So it's a repeat note, so it might sound kind of funny, but it works. Okay. So the tabs are accurate. I checked them multiple times. So if you're watching along with the tabs, just do exactly as the tabs say. All right, so this whole section is. Played with the rhythm. pay attention to what chords are going on underneath of the solo, and just try your best to get this phrasing down, okay? So I'm going as slow as possible to help you learn this. All right, so then the next part of this solo, again, we're on the G chord again, so it goes following the tabs. Rhythm section goes down to the E chord, so it's, and then he does another one of these signature pentatonic licks. Okay, so 12 on the E string, 15 on the B string, and a little bend of the 14 on the G string. Okay, and what he does here is he goes, this phrase with a, so a little bend release on the 14 of the G string down to the 12, and then a bend. Okay, so it's, so it sounds weird when you're just playing it by yourself, but played over top of the chord progression. So far we have this. Okay, you see what I'm doing there? Tabs are exactly what the tabs say, or exactly what I'm doing. One more time. Alright. So he ends that little phrase with a bend on the 14th fret. Alright, and then at that point he's soloing over the D chord, so this goes. So it's. Okay, so again, this one you want to start on the upbeat, so it's a hit. So it's always easier to do this with the rhythm playing behind me. Okay, so let me try this. Okay, so that's what he's doing over the D chord. Okay, so the final thing is he ends on the C, and he does, you're starting at the point where you're at this high bend on the 17th fret of the E string. Okay, and he ends the whole solo off by going. So you're already at that bend on the high 17. Then you hit the 15 of the E string, and you move down to the 14 and do a little bend up to that same note. So this whole phrase right here is all the whole round of chord progression, I mean. right, so we got through the hard part of the song. Now we just have a few more things to do. And this is the part that comes right after the solo. It does this cool chord. And basically all this chord is if you want to know the actual name for it, it's an E7 sharp 9. And that sharp 9 is what's giving it that tone right there. Okay, so all it is, if you're watching this from the website, you have the chord diagram and the tabs on the screen. If you're on YouTube, second fret, or middle finger, seventh fret, A string, first finger, sixth fret, D string, third finger, seventh fret, G string, and pinky, eighth fret, B string. Okay? Sounds like a Jimi Hendrix chord. So that's pretty much all he's doing for the breakdown. Then after he does that, he just comes in with a nice little bluesy riff. Back into the final chorus. And that bluesy riff is just on the A string, 7 to 5. And then 7, 6, 5 on the E. And open. Back into the chorus. So you got. Okay, pretty straightforward. And then the final chorus, it doesn't go around the whole progression. It just alternates between the G and the E. It doesn't go to the D and the C anymore. So the final chorus is going. Alright, and then even to mix it up, he throws in that same riff again. See what I'm doing? Just going from the G to the E. And then to end the song, he just does that same blues riff 3 times. Alright. So taking it from the breakdown, which is right after the solo. So that's the whole song. Hopefully you're able to learn something from that. I tried to meticulously walk through the solo section because, in my opinion, and I'm sure you probably agree, that that's the most difficult part of the song. So I tried to meticulously walk through and go over every single subtle nuance, including how each phrase starts, and played over, you know, a backing track of my own creation because I'm using my looper pedal. So with that said, if there's any questions or if I left anything out, feel free to ask. All right, thanks a lot.